sort of a laptop. So there was some sort of point at which it was vanishing, maybe. So this was the screen. The same way, suppose I imagine that there is some vanishing point, maybe far away. It doesn't have to be in the paper also, it can be out of the paper also. Sorry. So if this is going to be my screen, slightly tilted on one side, and then this also, I will try to see that it vanishes somewhere here, maybe far out here. That is also vanishing. So it is slightly increasing on this side. And then this is going to be the base. Now, if you look at this, it looks as if this distance is smaller than this distance right now. So I would say that this line is not accurate. So what I would do is possibly increase this a little bit with respect to the screen. Maybe make it slightly bigger so that now when I sort of close this laptop, it will fit exactly there. There could be some sort of hinges, something like that seen here. You can observe your own laptop also. See, there are so many other designs also in laptops. So it is not that all laptops are the same. So you can observe your own laptop. So there's a small bezel is there, called as a bezel. This border is called as a bezel. So there'll be a bezel here. Then there'll be some space where you have got this keyboard. The keyboard also has got a peculiar layout, as you can see. But you need not draw it in detail. You can simply just draw lines like this, which are vanishing towards the vanishing point, and maybe some keys. And the keys are actually not like a grid. They are slightly staggered, as you can see. If you observe your laptop, you'll see that the keys are not like in a grid. They are slightly staggered. So later on, when you make them slightly more elaborate, you can possibly stagger them a little bit. These are keys in a one row. Then the keys in the second row will get staggered a little bit here. And this will be the pad, touch pad or whatever they call it. Then show some thickness to that. And the various ports are there. There could be various types of ports. And then you can show something connected to that. Maybe a mouse. And then in the same perspective, now if we are talking about this perspective, what we are looking at is something like this. So if you show the table, let us say the table, the lines of the table would also vanish like that similarly, maybe somewhere here. So if there is a cup, maybe something like that, that also will be seen similarly with this. This is the same perspective with a saucer, maybe. So this could be a part of that. Maybe this would be dipping further down, I don't know, in perspective. Maybe this line is looking too steep. So I would just change it a little bit. With respect to the perspective, I thought that this line was looking too steep. So I'll make it more straighter. Now this looks a little better. So keep on changing. If you feel that something is going wrong, you can understand by intuition that, oh, this is not looking so good. There's something wrong with the sketch. Then you can change it also. So this is one thing which you can show here. Maybe you can show a notebook or something which has been kept here. Again, here also, keep the sense of the perspective so that And as they have shown, maybe you are sitting next to a window, maybe. So in the same perspective, you'll be also seeing maybe part of the window here in the glass. Moreover, keep your hand very free when you are drawing. Try to draw very freely. Doesn't matter even if you make mistakes. But don't keep your hand stiff. So this could be a window sill or something. This could be the frame. And then there could be some glazing here, glass. So maybe frame here. Like that. Maybe something like that could be there. Small pencil holder or something could be kept here. So that should be something.